And I would like to invite our next speaker, and that is Kirsten from Council Bay.
Doing super things.
Talking about terracotta project, potential of global experts in controlling the same kind of problems.
Then keep it in incubator conditions until the end of the experiment to quantify the presence of spots on their index. For the first experiment, is the combination of three hormone extracts. After inoculation, the combinations of three hormone extracts were dissolved in 90 persons in the serum, and each girl stimulated bees were fed respectively as well for the type 1. Group 1 and group 2 were the combinations of three hormone extracts at different concentrations. Group 3 to group 8 were the combinations of herbal of two herbal extracts by different concentrations. Group 9 to group 11 was the single herbal extracts. Group 12 was negative control, and group 13 was blank control. Each group has three replications with 35 honeybees. After 13 days of experiments, 5 bees were collected from each cage to assess the degree of Clostridium infection. Let's look at the result. Figure 1 is M393 cannabis worth cottons. Double star indicates extremely significant differences between treatments and group 12 on the same day. White star indicates significant differences between treatment and group 12. Endpoint S indicates no significant differences were detected between treatment and group 12. It suggested that each two combinations of three herbal extracts on single were reduced spots significantly. Figure 2 is M402 cannabis worth cottons. Double star indicates extremely significant differences between treatments and group 12 on the same day. It suggests that the combinations of three hormone extracts or single were reduced spots significantly. Figure 3 is M405. Cannabis worth cottons. Double star indicates extremely significant differences between treatment and group 12 on the same day. It suggests that a combination of three herbal extracts or single were reduced spots significantly. Now let's look at the second experiment to measure minerals in every angiography, pediculata, and the combination procedures. Group 1 to group 3 was three concentration of angiography light, angiography light. Group 4 to group 6 was three concentrations of dehydrated angiography light. Group 7 to group 9 was three concentrations of two major animals combination. And group 10 was angiographic paniculata. Group 11 was negative control, and group 12 was blank control. After 13 days of experiments, 5 bees were collected from each cage in order to assess the degree of Clostridium surrounding infection. Let's compare the result. Figure 4 is a cannabis worth cottons. Double star indicates extremely significant differences between treatments and group 11 on the same day, and no significant differences were detected between other groups and group 11. It suggests that a certain concentration of dehydroangiography light and the combination of two minerals will reduce spots significantly. all. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Is there any questions from you? Yes, please. We need the microphone. That's what we want. Microphone up here. As you know, the next speaker is not turning up, so we have extra time.
Thank you for the presentation. One of the things that usually is a challenge with plants that start is the fact that the plant secondary metabolites usually change depending on the distance of the plant. We have kind of chemotaxis. How you define this combination in aim to reach the practical level? You would like probably to develop kind of treatment, isn't it?
In our papers, in worst conditions, we have do some experiments about the herbal extract in inhibits the development of Nosema sarnia. We can suggest like three herbal extract can inhibit the Nosema sarnia infection. So we do the next experiment.
Do you plan to go to a pure compound at the end of the process or just the decoctions?
Is there any further questions? There's one there from the gentleman.
Thank you for your presentation. Why did you choose these three herbals? They are all Chinese herbals, I think we don't have them as well. What's the reason why did you choose these plants? Did you make some experiment before choosing these three plants?
We're just moving the microphone to the next question.
Şimdi bizim sorumuz şöyle olacak. Öncelikle teşekkür ediyoruz sunum için. Bu bitkilerin ekstraktinde yapıp esansiyel yağ olarak mı kullanmışlar yoksa kaynatıp suyunu mu kullanmışlar? Ve bunu nasıl kullanmışlar? Bunu besleme tarzında mı yoksa araya kontaminasyon tarzında mı kullanmışlar? Bunları merak ediyoruz.
Could you repeat the question? I don't think she got the question at the microphone.
Biz bitkilerin kullanımında ekstrakte edip esansiyel yağ olarak kullandılar yoksa kaynatıp suyunu mu kullandılar? Bunu merak ediyoruz. Ve bunu nasıl kullandılar? Yani besleme olarak mı kullandılar yoksa komutan diyeti olarak temas tarzında mı kullandılar? Kullanım oranları mı? Besleme tarzında ise o oranlar nasıl tespit edilir?
Okay, I think we did clear the Chinese language.